Hello and welcome to yet another fabulous opportunity. In today's video, we are going to talk about the fully funded Gates Cambridge Scholarship for Masters and PhD in the United Kingdom. This scholarship is open to all international students and it covers your full tuition fees, your flight tickets, monthly stipends of about £1,560, visa cost, your health insurance, your academic development fund, and even your family allowance. It also covers your fieldwork allowance as well as maternity and paternity funding. These benefits are super interesting. Therefore, give this video a like to show that you are interested to learn more about this scholarship, because in this video, we are going to talk about the following points. One, we're going to talk about important points that you should note in this scholarship. We're going to talk about the eligibility criteria, selection criteria, important documents that are necessary for this scholarship. We're also going to talk about how you can find a course at Cambridge University. And finally, and most interestingly, we're going to talk about how you can apply to this scholarship. So therefore, sit tight, get a pen and a paper, and let's get into it. But before we get started, make sure to hit the like button, and if this is your first time, my name is Eugene and this is the homeland of international opportunities. Make sure to join the family by hitting the subscribe button and turn on the bell notification so that you will be the first to be notified whenever I drop a fabulous opportunity like this. So guys, I just launched my scholarship ebook that will guide you to win an international scholarship. Make sure you get that ebook with the first link in the description below or in the comment section. Now let's get into the Gates Cambridge Scholarship presentation. Okay guys, let's get started, and we're going to start with first the important points. And yeah, this scholarship is the Gates Cambridge Scholarship, and it is offered at the Cambridge University in the United Kingdom. This scholarship was established in October 2000. And it is a fully funded scholarship, and it's for masters and PhD. And like I've already said, all countries are eligible, except in the UK. So all other countries are eligible, and it is a one-way application, which means that you apply for the scholarship as you are applying for admission. So you don't have to submit application for the admission and then submit a separate application for scholarship. You are going to submit all your documents, and there are specific documents for the scholarship which you are going to submit along the way. So make sure you stick to this video, and we are going to talk about the application process later on in this presentation. So you also need to note that there are no application fee for the scholarship, and there are no age limits, and you can move with your family. And IELTS is not mandatory for the scholarship, but you must make sure you meet any criteria to prove your English proficiency. And the deadline for this scholarship is October 12, 2022. So let's move into the scholarship benefit. Like I already mentioned, so it covers your full tuition, your flight ticket, monthly stipends. You get about £1,562 every month. So it also covers your visa cost, and health insurance is covered. You get academic development fund. So for family allowance, if you are if you have one child, you get up to £10,900 for one child. And then for two children or above, you get £15,600. Interesting. So it also covers a fieldwork allowance if you have to go to the field. And also, for example, if your wife put to bed or you have a child, it also covers your maternity or paternity funding. So let's go into the eligibility without wasting time. So who is eligible for this scholarship? So how do you know you're eligible for this scholarship? So first, you have to be a citizen of any country outside the United Kingdom, and then you should be pursuing a PhD full-time or part-time, or a master's program like MLIT, and also any other one-year postgraduate courses like MSc or any other master's program full-time. So some of the courses that are not eligible include bachelor's courses. Any bachelor's course is not eligible. So business, doctorate or MBA, Masters of Business Administration, and Masters of Finance, and also Doctor of Medicine, and any other program that is a non-degree course. So those courses are not eligible. So you also check through the website you'll find out more about the courses that are eligible. So normally any taught course, 1 year master's program in the United Kingdom in the Cambridge University is eligible. So let's take a look at the selection criteria. So now pay good attention because this is very, very important. This is what they look at to select a candidate to say, okay, you have won this scholarship. So first of all, they look at your academic excellence. So this scholarship has not mentioned 2-1 or first class or anything. But then they also look at the academic excellence, and this is not just about your grade. They will take a look at your transcript. They will also take a look at the references you are going to submit from your lecturers, your professors, or your previous supervisors. And they also take a look at your experience. What experience do you have? So all this come together to talk about your academic excellence. So you must show that you have some kind of academic excellence. And another point that they look at is the reason for the choice of course. So why are you picking that particular course? So you have to make a very strong case. And one way you can do that is to demonstrate how your academic background and your skills will help you to perform well in the particular course you have chosen. So this is very, very important. And you can also demonstrate how this course you have chosen would facilitate your future career. So depending on what you want to do in your future, they want to know how the course that you have chosen is going to help you in your future career. So you have to pay key attention to this, and this has to come in your statement of purpose or your letter of motivation. We are going to come into that soon. Another selection criteria is commitment to improving lives of others. So whatever you are going to write down should show that you are committed in improving the lives of others. You care about the lives of others in the community, in your country, or what have you. And lastly, this is the fourth selection criteria, is leadership capacity. You want to show that you have that leadership capacity inbuilt in you. So there are different ways you can demonstrate this. More reasons why you need to get my ebook. So let's talk about the documents that are needed. So apart from every other important document like your degree certificates and your transcript, you would need 2 academic reference letters. These are letters from your previous lecturers or your supervisors, and this is for admission purpose. And then for the scholarship purpose, you will need 1 Gate Cambridge reference. So this reference has to be written by someone. Maybe it can be your previous supervisor. Also, it can be someone that has written 1 of the 2 academic letter. It does not matter, but it does not have to be a family member. It does not have to be a friend. It can be your previous supervisor from your first degree. It can be your boss at your workplace, someone who knows you and can prove a lot of points when it comes to the criteria for the Gates Cambridge scholarship. And another important document is the Gates Cambridge statement. This is like the statement of purpose, or what you call letter of motivation. So this is a very important document. Like I always say, it is one of the document that will determine if you are going to get a scholarship or not. This is where you are able to convince your reviewer. So in this statement of purpose, you want to explain why you are applying for the course, the particular degree that you have applied to. You want to explain why, the reasons. You want to explain why you are applying for the course. What are the reasons? How it's going to benefit you? How it's going to benefit your home country? So these are the kind of things that you want to write down on this statement. And also, you want to talk about how you meet the 4 selection criteria. We talked about the 4 selection criteria, as you can see back here. We talked about the selection criteria. So you want to write down how you have met these 4 selection criteria. And then for PhD students only, you will need a research proposal. PhD students also need to contact a supervisor before they apply to this scholarship. And but for master students, you don't have to contact a supervisor. And then you need your degree certificate, like I've mentioned, and then your transcript. Now let's go into how to find a course and how to apply for this scholarship. So what you need to do right now before we proceed is to hit the like button, because it's a way to spread the love and it's a way to help me promote my channel. And also hit the subscribe button if you're not subscribed and turn on the bell notification. And then you want to go down and visit the link in the description box. I'll also make sure I put the link in the comment section so that you can easily click the link from there. So that link will take you to where we are going to go to right now. Click the link. It's going to take you right to this page at upnextnigeria.com. And right here, you can read about the scholarship and everything that I've talked about. You can see them right here. And then you can read through. And what you basically want to do after reading is to come down right here. So at the bottom of this post, you're going to find two important links. So the first link is to browse for courses. If you click on this link, it's going to take you to the course catalog where you can browse for any course right at the University of Cambridge. So once you've gotten the course, you can come back here and click on the Gates Cambridge Scholarship. This will take you to the official website. So first, let's go to the courses. Let's check out the courses. So I'm going to click on this. And right here, you can see we are now at the University of Cambridge. And you can see the courses. I can search for any course I want right here. And then you want to put the name of the course or whatever you want to search for right here, the keyword. So it says enter keyword. And then if I'm looking for a master's, I'm going to tick master's. And then if I want just a thought course, I'm going to tick course thoughts. So you can see it's going to give me some master courses. All these courses are eligible. You can see they have to be 1 year, within 1 year. Okay, let's put it at full time, because it has to be a full time if I'm going for master's. So these are courses that are 1 year. So I can apply to these, any of these courses. So there are a lot of courses. We're not going to look at each of the courses. So there are a lot of courses right here. Okay. So this is basically how to look for a course. If you are looking for a doctoral program, you can select the doctoral box, and then you can find some other PhD courses, as you can see right here. Okay, so that is about how to find a course. And then if you get a course, you can click on it to read more about it and read about the eligibility about that particular course. You want to fulfill those eligibility also. So now let's go back to upnextnigeria.com, and then we can come back to click on the Gates Cambridge scholarship. This will take us to the official website. So right here, you can see this is the official website of the Gates Cambridge scholarship. Like I always say, it is very, very important to read all the details on this website. So first of all, what you can see right here is the timeline. You can see the deadline and when the scholarship opened. The scholarship opened on the 15th of September, and it's going to close 12th of October. So you can see when you are going to be notified right here, December 9th. That's when you are going to be notified if you have gotten the scholarship or not. So I encourage everyone to apply to this scholarship, because it is very important. I will want more scholarship winners. I want to interview more persons on this channel who have won a scholarship. So you can see right here everything you need to know, and then other important things you need to look at. Like, you can click on eligibility, you can check out the scholarship. You're going to find the benefits right here. So there are important links right here that you want to check out. Make sure you check out the links and read through the page before you apply. So once you are satisfied, you can go to how to apply. So okay, also make sure you read how we select and criteria. So make sure you read that also. And then we can go to how to apply. So once we come to this link, how to apply, you can see the application process. So application for this scholarship is online, and it is basically done on the University of Cambridge application portal. So the application form on that portal would have two sessions. So there's the admission session where you are going to fill in and submit all the documents they require for admission. And then below that session, you are going to find the funding session. There you are going to tick a box that you want to apply for the Gates Cambridge scholarship. So if you tick that box, then they are going to ask you to provide the Gates Cambridge. They are going to ask you to provide the Gates Cambridge statements, like I told you before. So make sure you read this test here to guide you on how to provide that statement, what you should put in that statement and everything. And then for PhD, the research proposal, and then the Gates Cambridge reference. Another important point, make sure you read through this Gates Cambridge reference. Like I said, you need to submit 2 reference letters, that is for admission, and then 1 reference letter for the Cambridge scholarship. So this Gates Cambridge reference letter, all the important points are stated at here. Who should write that reference letter, who should not write that reference letter. So make sure you read it, and what should be included in that reference letter. So you want to get those information so that you give it to your supervisor, or you give it to your the lecturer or a professor who is going to write it for you, or maybe your employer. You give it to that person, you give those information to that person, so that the person will guide you, will be able to write a very good reference for you, because this document is also very important. So therefore, hit the like button if you haven't, and also let me know in the comment section if you are going to apply to this scholarship or not. Let me know what type of scholarship you want, and which country you want to apply to, so that I can provide scholarships that fit what you need. Okay, so once you are done reading all the necessary information on this page, the next thing you want to do is to click on apply now. So you click on the apply now button, it takes you to the application of the University of Cambridge. And all you need to do right here, you don't need to do much, just click on this button right at the top. You can see application, applicants portal. So I'm going to click on the applicants portal. It takes me to a new page where I can register. If I don't have an account, I have to register. So you can click on this button right here, click here to register. So once you click on that, it's going to give you the registration form, and then you register. After registration, you can come back and log in. So once you have logged in, it takes you to the application portal. So right there, you can begin to submit all the necessary documents. So that is it. It is that simple. So encourage you to apply to this scholarship. Let me know if you're applying in the comment section. You can watch this next video on Erasmus Mundus fully funded scholarship in Europe.